Night of Destruction number 5, the final Night of Destruction of 2015, season 3 of the Low Budgets, and Tommy, we've made it. It's taken hell to get here, but what a year it's been, and now we finish it all off.
You know what? Some tell me this is probably not the last event of the year for some reason. I don't know why. No, it is. I don't think we'll have many cars left after this one. Jeffrey, getting ready for the Enduro race. You know, looking back at the season, how many different cars we've driven, how many different cars we've wrecked and had to build and rebuild. It all comes down to this night. This is where we either get rid of cars or add more work to our workflow for the next year.
We have 5 events. Some of them throughout the year we've had 4. So this one hitting that 5 event marker, starting with the Enduro.
Yep.
And you get to, for the first time ever, try out your hatchback.
You know, Jeffrey, as you remember last time, Night of Destruction,
I forgot
to put seatbelts in.
It's hard to forget.
And I redeemed myself. That was the first thing I did after that Night of Destruction.
Yep.
So that's seat belts. They're in. I got 2 lap belts I'm going to connect to, and we tried it out and it works.
Yeah, so excited to see what goes on here. However, I just want to point out, when you did try on that seat belt,
it was tight.
It was, and you didn't have a driver's seat on, so we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's only a little bit different.
It'll be exciting, I'm sure. And then I'll be taken out for the last time, Rainbow Dash.
Yeah, you're going to be doing double duty in that car.
I will be. She'll be also in the Demolition
Derby. At least that's
the plan. That is the plan. So I have to make sure that car makes it off the track. And then Shayla's going to be taking out a new car for her Enduro.
Yeah, Shayla's going to be swapping out a pick your pair car. She's running her Mario Kart car that you've seen her run all this year, the red Honda, and the Demolition Derby, because it has transmission problems. So she got another Toyota that should be running in the Enduro here this evening.
Yeah, so a stacked night of events. We're going to be doing some juggling at one point. We'll talk a little bit about that during the next event. But Tommy, you ready to go racing in the Enduro?
Hey, I can't wait to see how long my hatchback lasts.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's start the beginning of the end.
Ha ha ha. Gotta think small. You want to come over here real quick? How the hell is the seatbelt going in?
They only just now went green.
Yeah, I know.
What do you need me to do?
Try to see how I can get this in here. Can you push in? Ready? Go. I'm just trying to move my fire suit out of the way.
Am I hurting you?
Nope.
This is like that time when we went to Knott's Berry Farm. I don't know, man. This one go out more?
No, I don't think so. No, I think it's maxed out. Hang on. Go ahead.
Huh?
Go ahead.
Go ahead what?
Go race. I'll figure this one out.
You sure?
Yeah. Now hang on. If anything, I'll just jump into another car.
Ah.
Thank you.
with you. Besides, now I'm just ensuring more that that car makes it to the Derby.
This one?
Maybe.
Why is that?
I don't know, I'm just saying.
Go race, Trevor, I'm good.
You sure?
If anything, halfway, I'll catch up with you and sit in your car.
Okay. Flag me down. If I don't see you, I'll look for you on the back straighter. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Yep.
Did you get it?
Well, I feel like I'm so close, but this fire suit is tricking.
Take the fire suit off.
There we go.
Oh!
There we go, we're racing now. This car had no seatbelts, so I had to put my own seatbelt in, and it's just in the weirdest spot, so I can't really adjust it anymore. It's okay, this car is not the favorite of the bunch. Here we go. Enduro, the first time ever in this little Honda Civic hatchback. This car is so bumpy, it's got no suspension. I've been told that this thing can handle like gibberish. I don't even know how that handles, but we'll see.
Ready?
I'm going racing.
You ready?
Yeah.
Wait, hold on a second.
Let's go have some fun. My big thing right now is not destroying this car because it needs to run. The
Demolition Derby. Transmission flipping. And we have a car upside down.
There's a car that rolled over. And I lost my key. My screwdriver. So I'm looking for my key. There's a bunch of crap in here. Okay, my key's in my pocket. Thank goodness. Here we... Well, one race, 12 laps in, someone's already rolled over. This car is a mess.
Get out of the way. Sorry, Mike.
Transmission's bad. Handling's horrible. But hey, we're out here having fun. And I've got less than half a tank. And I think I put 2 gallons in it.
So I'm gonna set up cameras right now, the red flag's out. But I realize this is my opportunity to set up some cameras and save me time later.
I can't adjust it. Yeah.
How bouncy is it?
It's so bouncy.
Does that look like
I'm pretty sure the wheels come off the ground.
Does that look like it's facing the right direction?
Yeah. It's aiming right at me.
So it should catch everything going up here. Yeah. I was like, red flag.
Go ahead and get ready.
Yeah. How the hell did that car get upside down?
I don't know. I have no idea. All I thought was one of Mike's cars too.
I know. All right. I think I have two more cameras to set up in the race.
Yeah. Jeffrey, take a lap behind me.
Huh?
Take a lap behind me.
Damn, not on the top 10 after being 10 laps down. There's Jeremy going into reverse.
Thank you. gonna get rainbow dead 2.0!
I wanna get the soccer ball out right now. Pretty good, I mean.
Yeah.
soccer ball.
I don't think they liked my soccer ball.
Red flag again, lap number 35, five to go. I've been shortcutting and cheating this whole race. I'm gonna make them disqualify me. The other soccer ball went on the track. And if I could only guess, it was Jeffrey who did that. So after this race, I gotta go upstairs and work the camera for the auto soccer. After auto soccer, I gotta go back into the pits and get this car ready for the skid plate race. If you were wondering. Which I know you weren't. Because I like to pause in the middle of my sentences.
So we might have knocked one car out of the derby, that 33 goes like a toy. So after this, there's gonna be a race that we're not gonna be in. It's an officials race. After that is auto soccer. Now, when we get to auto soccer, I don't know what to expect. I don't know if we're gonna have some hard hits. I don't know if it's gonna be nice. I don't know at all what to expect. It's probably gonna hurt. So yeah. What? No. But I thought I wanted to play soccer. Did you see me hit it? Or did you just know? I'm guessing you figured that was me pretty quick. Yeah.
Are you enjoying my shortcut?
I loved when you cut through that. Did you see the 33?
Yeah.
He pretty much drove straight into the wall.
Really?
Yeah. Why'd you spin out?
I went to lie.
I loved when you were chasing me down.
Yeah.
They didn't want to play soccer.
I don't know.
I hit the ball.
I wonder why. Yeah. Oh, what the hell?
Nobody loves me. My car's so quiet. What up?
Thank you.
Watch it give me a flat tire. Good for me. So I'm doing my last check here to make sure all the cameras are running and everyone's happy and they're no shit.
That was a fun little goofy race. This car is definitely not one of my favorites, but it is goofy and fun. Enduro done, the car still runs. Time for skid play racing for this thing next. Now I get to go upstairs and switch out with Matt.
The Enduro is complete, and boy, did it have a fun beginning and an extra fun end.
I didn't know one car that ran all the laps. Shayla.
Yeah. So Shayla, oh, I guess we could start with her. She made it out on the track. She lined up. She had no idea how low budget her boyfriend and her boyfriend's best friend are. So she went out there. Looked like she had
kept the car clean. She was saying something about the car that it's funny when you look back on the video, as you see. That car was rolling pretty heavily. Like, it was tilting side to side. She said that the steering was really slow in the way of, like, she'd have to put, like, 3 rounds of steering wheel in just to make a corner. And to add to it, one thing she didn't like about the car is how much it leans over. She felt like she's going to roll it over every corner.
Was it a boat?
Oh, apparently. So she's excited to do that in a Demolition Derby and came away with, I think, a 12th. 12th place finish.
Well, not bad.
So, not bad at all. And let's talk about the exciting moments.
All right. So, I guess the ultimate exciting moment. First off, Shayla did get taken out at one point in that race.
Yeah, I don't know by who.
Don't know if anyone noticed.
Yeah, maybe there was a camera that captured it.
Probably not. Speaking of cameras that didn't capture it, folks, you may have noticed that at the beginning of the race, there were only a few cameras to pick from. pick and choose. And that's because it's almost just as much fun talking about the race as it is about the camera management before the race. So I pulled onto the racetrack. I did the autograph session. And then once the autograph session was over, I went to set up all the cameras. Tommy and I previously that day had picked up a bunch of memory cards. I didn't make the connection that all the memory cards we had picked up were supposed to go in all the camcorders. And I opened all of them up and there were no memory cards. And my heart dropped because I'm like, we forgot.
Charge the batteries, but there's no footage.
We're not going to be able to film. Oh, crap. And then and once I pulled into the pit area, and I'm like, Tommy! Oh, shoot. And then that's when you reconfirmed Jeffrey, the memory cards are back there. So I had to get creative with how and when I was going to set up all the cameras. Now, Tommy, that's a story I will continue with. We didn't make it on the track quite on time.
We were worried about cameras. But the biggest issue was my car, my seatbelts. We called it. Yeah. We never checked it with the fire suit on. So I got in my car, and I was trying to click it, and I was like, this worked literally last week. Mm-hmm. Why is it not working now? Yeah. I didn't gain a pound, I don't think, but apparently I did. And then I was like, you know what, Jeffrey, we spent too much time on this. If I sit out of this one, it's ready to go for the skid plates. So I can figure out what to do for that. Mm-hmm. Just go race. I don't want to hold you back. So you went out on the track and took off.
No, I didn't.
You didn't?
No, I didn't.
Why not?
I stayed out there waiting for you.
Oh, okay. So I
was there. Now here's the – do you want to redo that part a little bit?
Sure.
Okay. I wasn't sure if you were joking or not. Now, with Tommy having these –
I thought you drove – okay,
no,
go ahead.
I waited until you started pulling away.
Okay.
You and I pulled out together.
Oh,
which
I
is,
forgot.
Which
okay.
is why I know you completed more than zero laps. Uh-huh. Maybe. So I see Tommy struggling with this thing, and I know that there's a chance the race has already started. We can't tell from our pit area if it has.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I'm like, I'm not willing to give up on my man. Uh-huh. So I am going to help out Tommy as best as I can through thick and thin. We're going to make it out on that damn racetrack together and see how it goes. And, yeah, no, I stuck it right in there with you.
Yeah, you're helping me out. I couldn't get this thing to latch, and I was so confused.
Yeah.
But when you walked back to the car, I was like, well, wait a minute. This seatbelt setup is kind of crooked and weird.
Yep.
So right then is when I remembered, I had to shift my body before I sat in it correctly. So I literally did all of a quarter, maybe even less than that, a fifth of a turn to connect the seatbelt, latch it. I'm like, okay, we're good. Yep. And then I sat down straight and we took off.
Yeah, it was a wild setup just to get to that point. But then we made it on the track.
Got it on the
track. And boy, did we follow the rules of the speedway.
Oh, yes.
One of us kind of did. Tommy, you were just going through every nook and cranny you could find.
I was nine laps down at that point, or however many laps we missed. And I just wanted to go out there and have fun. So
I think mission accomplished.
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I at one point got in a little bit of trouble myself. I caused a red flag.
You did? Because you're trying to play auto soccer.
I wanted some practice. So, you know, we were being goofballs on the racetrack, and I found the soccer ball. And I'm like, you know what? I want to know what they'll do when the soccer ball rolls all over the place. Well, the red flag came out. And I kind of just sat back. But I was laughing. That was just a goofy, funny event. Now, we rolled a car upside down in that race.
Yeah.
Not us personally.
Uh-huh.
But a competitor did. Now, Tommy, this is what I mean by I had to get creative with the camera. When I pulled out on the racetrack, I guess the officials didn't notice. It's a good thing. That I was driving with one hand. Because in my other hand, I was holding a tripod, a camera, and a camera bag full of camcorders. I was having to hold it back on the passenger seat in order to get these cameras on the track. Now, when the red flag came out, I went, perfect, opportunity to set up the cameras. Yeah. And that's why after the red flag, all of a sudden
we've got cameras. Yeah, we got cameras.
So that was just, it was just a hectic start, but it's not unusual for it to be hectic during Night of Destruction. Tommy, it was the last Enduro of the year. Mm-hmm. Definitely probably one of the more memorable Enduros of the year.
A fun Enduro. Hey, we had cars that we didn't know how they're going to work out. My car finished off the race. I pulled it off, and I'm ready to do skid plates next. Jeffrey, your car did the same.
Yeah, so I finished, where was it, though?
17th, and I believe I finished 31st on the scoring sheet. Granted, my car had no transponder on it, and it didn't even score a lap, and your car did.
Yeah, so
I would have been right there with you, but I would have disqualified myself pretty quickly, being that I was cutting the course all different ways.
Yeah.
I was running in third
did
mile.
Did I finish 17th or 26th?
Or
who even pays attention? don't know. But yeah, no, what a wild event it was. And Tommy, next up is an event you're going to sit out of.
Correct. Auto soccer.
Auto soccer.
Coming up next.